Good morning, fourth grade. We are ready for language lesson 154. Today we're going to start off with going over punctuation a bit. I have a sentence here at the top of the board. You get to do some of this in your lesson today as well. So we have, he said, I'm sorry, I will be late for dinner. We need to add our punctuation, that's not supposed to be there yet, and our capitalization. Now this sentence has a quotation, so let's remember there are about three things specifically that we need to remember when we punctuate direct quotations. And remember, a direct quotation is a person's exact words. So let's look at this sentence. He said, I'm sorry, I will be late for dinner. Now, first of all, we know that the beginning of our sentence, the first word of every sentence, needs to be capitalized. So we can do that right away. Now, we also know that we need ending punctuation. So do we need exclamation, question mark, period? I think the sentence, we would just need a period, okay? So now, let's look at our direct quotation. A direct quotation needs quotation marks around the exact words that someone said. So he said, I'm sorry, I will be late for dinner. Another thing that we need in a direct quotation is that the first word of the quotation needs to be capitalized. So capitalize I'm, and we also need an apostrophe in I'm. Then, between where it says who said the quotation and what they said, we need a comma. So he said, I'm sorry, I will be late for dinner. So we have a comma in between who said it and what he said. We have our quotation marks. We have our first word capitalized. We also need a comma here. I'm sorry, I will be late for dinner. Now that is complete. That is correct. So watch carefully when you do your punctuation in your lesson today and capitalization. Be very careful with that. That's something that you need to watch. Make sure you don't miss anything. Next of all, I have another sentence here. The little girl carefully placed the flowers in the vase. We're going to label the different words in this sentence, and then I'm going to diagram it. So look at the sentence and figure out what is the verb. What is the verb in this sentence, the action or being? Place is our verb. Let's just write a V above it there. Now, who or what placed? Girl, right? So girl is the subject. Now, we're going to label just the first part here and diagram just that part. Now, what are the and little? What are they doing? Those are describing words. What are they describing? They're describing girl. So girl is a noun, which makes these adjectives. And then carefully is also a describing word, but what is carefully describing? Carefully is describing placed. Placed is a verb. What kind of words describe verbs? Adverbs, right? So when we would diagram this, we would put a straight line, with a line dividing in the center, our subject goes to the left, and our verb goes to the right. Now, our describing words go right underneath the words that they're describing. So, the and little would go right here, and carefully would go underneath place. And that takes care of what we're going to diagram. The little girl carefully placed. We have our subject, verbs, and modifiers diagrammed. In our lesson today, we are talking about how to use sit and set correctly. Now, I have a chart here that shows the meaning of them. So, first of all, the word sit means to rest or be seated. The word set means to put or place something. Now, do you see the difference? So if you're going to sit down somewhere, this is the word you use. Or whenever something is resting and being seated, you use sit. Now, whenever you're placing something is when you use set. There are four forms of each of these words. We have sit, sitting, sat, and have sat. We have set, said, example sentence here for each of them. For the word sit, you could say, Tim and I sit in the same row. For sitting, Tim is sitting two seats behind me. He sat there last month also. That's the past form of sit. He has sat there all year, or we have sat there all year. Now for set these heavy grocery sacks down. Luke is setting my hat on the shelf. Yesterday, Ella set the baby in Grandpa's lap. Now here's the past. The past of set would be actually the same as the present. Or if you're commanding someone to do something, set this down. The past of set is the same as that, actually. And then, I have always set my umbrella in the rack. So these are the different forms of the word set, but each form means to put or place something. Each of these forms of sit, though they're a bit different from each other, mean to rest or be seated. You need to fill in the correct form for some sentences in your book today. Now, whenever you use a form of the word set, remember that word means to put or place something. So you have to name the object that is being put or placed. Be careful not to miss that. In your sentences, in your book, when you write down either sit or set, if you use set, they're going to get you to find the object that is being put or placed. Now, turn the page on page 238. It talks about how the word set has come to actually have a lot more meanings than just this right here. A few of them are the sun sets in the west. What does that mean? That's just saying like the sun is going down the west, right? What about set the table for supper? That means set the knives, the forks, the spoons, the plates, the cups. The jello is not set yet. We usually say the jello is set when it's finished. It's hardened a little, not actually hard, but more rubbery rather than just a liquid. Jamie set his watch. That's setting the right time, okay? So set is used in a lot of different ways, and read the rest there to yourself. You'll be making some sentences with some of these words, correcting more punctuation and capitalization, as I said before. Work your lesson carefully. Let me know if you have any questions. And I hope you have a good rest of your day. Be careful to make sure you get each section done.